Hey everyone, welcome back to another exciting tutorial. Today we are diving into something super important for digital systems, which is memory components. Whether you are designing a CPU or just curious about how your computer stores information, this video is for you. We will be breaking down the two types of memory you need to know, RAM and ROM, and show you how to design and simulate these in Logisim. Plus, we will tackle memory addressing, the secret behind how data is stored and retrieved. Alright, let's start with the basics. Memory is like the brain of your digital system. It stores information or data for the CPU to work with. Now, there are two key players here. Number one, random access memory, RAM. Think of this as your desk. It's where you put everything you are working on right now. But once you walk away, or the power goes off, everything disappears. Number two, read-only memory, ROM. This is like a bookshelf where you keep all your important books. It stays the same even if you turn off the lights. Let's start with RAM, the fast but temporary memory. It's volatile, which means it's like a whiteboard. As soon as you wipe it or turn off the power, it's gone. RAM is where your computer stores the stuff it needs right now. In terms of speed, it's fast, which is why it is so crucial for smooth performance. There are two flavors of RAM. Number one, static RAM, SRAM. It's like instant coffee. It's quick, but a bit pricey. Number two is dynamic RAM, DRAM. It's like brewing your own coffee. Takes a little longer, but costs way less. Now, let's hop into Logisim and design a RAM module. Don't worry, it's easier than you think. First, we will drop the RAM component in Logisim by going into the memory and select the RAM and drag it into our canvas. For today's design, let's configure it with 8 address bit, which will give us 256 memory locations. We will also set the data width to 8 bits, so each location can hold an 8 bit value. Now, let's add control signals to read and write data. Imagine you are writing and erasing data on a whiteboard, just faster and digital. So, first we are going to add a control pin here, which will going to operate the memory. Either it needs to store some information or do we have to read from the memory. It's like a read enable or a write enable signal. So we are going to connect it with our LD pin here, which shows the load pin. Second, we will going to take an input pin and connect it with our address. As you can see, the RAM address is of 8 bits, so we have to convert our input pin to 8 pins as well. So we are changing its database from 1 to 8. Now we are also going to connect an output pin to the output D and convert the data bits of output from 1 to 8. Simple, right? So let's simulate it and see. Initially, we can see all the address bits is of 0. So I'm just going to click a random location in the memory so I can store some data in it. Here I can save 45. Let's say here I'm saying 34, here I'm saying 67, here we are saying 02, and here we are saying let's say 08. And we can, if we press the enter, you can see the locations of the memory goes forward. So let's now change the address bits and address to see if we are getting the exact data or not. As you can see, right now the load signal is 0, which means that I am storing some data into my memory. Now if I want to read the data, so I am going to convert it to 1, and here you can see the address shows the 0 and I am getting the output from the memory location. Here you can see at the 08 location we have a data 67, so let's change the address to 8. So you can see the 8 location becomes dark here and I am getting the output of 67. If we want to see the output of 08, So let's change, you can count the address here by, if we are at the 08 position and the second word is a 0C and the third is 10, so definitely this address will be of 15. So let's toggle last 4 bits to 1, and here you can see we are at the location here and we are getting the data which is 08 in the memory at the output pin. See, that's so easy for the RAM. Next up is ROM, the read only memory. Unlike RAM, ROM is non-volatile, meaning it keeps its data safe even when your power gets off. It's like having a post-it note that never loses its thickness. ROM is the go-to for storing essential information. Think of it like the rule book that the CPU follows. We will take a look at a couple of ROM types. Number 1, programmable ROM, PROM. Once you write it, that's it. It's permanent. Number 2, electrically erasable ROM, EEPROM. Like an etch a sketch, you can erase it and write something new. Now let's jump into Logisim and design our own ROM. We will preload some data and simulate the CPU reads from it. So in Logisim, let's add a ROM component and preload it with some simple data. We will simulate it how the CPU retrieves its permanent information by changing the address input. So select the ROM component and drag it to inner canvas. Here you can see we have only 2 pins. Number 1 is address and number 2 is data. We are configuring the ROM in the same configuration of 8 data bits and 8 address bits. So I'm just going to connect the address pin here and the output pin to the D. Now go to the simulation and let's just preload some data here. So we are going to write 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07, 08. Alright, now let's see at when we are at address 0, we are getting an output of 01. Let's change the address to 1, so you can see we are now getting the output of 2. If I change the address to 10, which is makes it 2, now I'm accessing the third location and I'm getting an output of 3. Let's make it 6. Now you can see we are getting an output of 7. And if we make it 7, we are getting output of 8. And if we change it to something like this, so you are getting all output as 0 because we haven't saved anything here. So this is how ROM works. Easy peasy. Now let's move towards the memory addressing. Imagine you have a huge library filled with books but without labels or numbers. It would be impossible to find a specific book, right? Well, in digital system, memory addressing is how we label different locations in memory to make sure we can access the exact data we need. In technical terms, memory addressing is the process of assigning a unique binary number or address to each memory location. This allows us to store and retrieve data from specific spots in memory. The more address line we have, the more memory location we can access. For example, if we have 4 address lines, we can access 2^4, which makes it equals to 16 unique memory locations. It's like having 16 drawers in a filing cabinet, and each drawer has a label so you know exactly where to look. Let's jump into Logisim to see how this works. For our memory addressing tutorial, we will use a RAM module. We will connect an address 4 lines to the RAM. So just drag the RAM component and place into the canvas. Now change its address bit to 4 and also changing its data bit to 4. By making an address bit of 4 lines, here you can see it giving us access to 16 unique memory locations. Think of these address lines as the labels for each memory location. Next, we will store some data in a few of these locations. For example, at address 0001, we will store the binary value of 1010, which makes it of 10. In hexadecimal, you can write it as A. In location at address 0010, which means 2, we will store the value of 1100, which makes its value of 12. In, you can say in hexadecimal, it's C. Now, let's connect the address pin here and also the data output pin here and change its data bits from 8 to 4. Now, by changing the address input in Logisim, we can access different locations in the RAM. Let's try it out. If we set the address to 0001, we should see 1010 at the output. If we change the address to 0010, we will see 1100. This is how memory addressing works in digital system. By using unique addresses, we can easily access specific locations in the memory to store and retrieve data. Now, we are going to level up and design a full-on memory-based system in Logisim. We will combine everything we have learned about RAM, ROM, and memory addressing to build a system that operates just like a real CPU, switching between temporary and permanent data seamlessly. In a memory system, the CPU needs to access both temporary data stored in RAM and permanent instructions stored in ROM. But how does the CPU decide which one to access? That's where control signals and multiplexers, MUX for short, comes into play. In this example, we will set up two separate memory modules, RAM and ROM. Both will share the same 4 address line, giving us 16 memory locations each. However, the CPU will use a control signal to decide whether to access data from RAM or ROM. Next, we will write the data lines from both RAM and ROM to a multiplexer. The MUX will act as a gatekeeper, deciding which memory's data will be read based on the control signal. Think of it as a traffic cop, directing whether we read from RAM or ROM. Now comes the crucial part, the control signal. We will connect the control signal to the select line of the MUX. So let's move towards the Logisim and build the current circuit there, and then we will go forward. Coming back to the Logisim, here we have already placed a RAM here of 4-bit address line and 4-bit data. So we are just going to connect a ROM here. And we are going to connect the same address input to the ROM as well. And let's just place one of output to the output as well. So first we are going to change the memory size here from 8 address lines to 4 and 8 database to 4. Now let's save some information on same addresses here. At RAM, we have saved A at the second 2 location or 1 location. Here we can save like 5, and here I am saving like value of 8. Now we are going to add a MUX here. One of the input of the MUX will coming from the RAM. Okay, changing the MUX database from 1 to 4, and one of the input will be coming from the ROM. we are going to connect an output signal to the mux here, and let's place a single input which will be using as a control signal. Here we go. Now, if the control signal is zero, the mux will output data from RAM. If the control signal is one, mux will output data from ROM. This stimulates how CPU decides where to read from RAM temporary data or ROM permanent instructions based on what's needed. Finally, we will connect the output of the mux to an output pin in Logisim. Now we can see which memory module is being accessed based on the control signal and the current address inputs. Now let's test it. So let's change the address to all zero. Here you can see the both data coming from RAM and ROM are zero here. Since our control signal is zero here, so we cannot distinguish from where the data we are getting read. So let's change the address to one. Now you can see from RAM we are getting a data of A and from ROM we are getting a value of 5. As the control signal is 0, so data output at the mux side is from the RAM. If I change it control signal to 1, you can see the data output we are getting is of ROM. Let's change the address to 2. You can see the current output we are getting is of 8, which is coming from ROM. If we toggle back the control signal to 0, we are getting the output of 12, which is from the RAM side. Boom! We have just designed RAM, ROM, and explore memory addressing all within Logisim. Now you know the basics of how digital system manage and store data. RAM for short-term stuff, ROM for permanent, and addressing to keep it all organized. In the next tutorial, we will dive even deeper into CPU components like the control unit. So if you are curious about how the brain of your computer works, be sure to stick around. And hey, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe for more awesome digital design content. See you next time.